flagship phone, that is, Galaxy S7. So let us check. The Samsung Galaxy S6 and the Galaxy S6 Edge, released at the start of 2015, proved to be two of the most exciting handsets on the market right now, and we gave them both near-on perfect reviews, with only a few little problems on each, letting them down. Those problems need to be ironed out by the next time around, and it's exciting to think what Samsung will be able to pull off, with its newfound ease of design changes, and true innovation. Samsung has built a name for itself as a premium phone manufacturer off the back of the Galaxy S series, so everyone is excited to see what's in store for the Galaxy S7. One of the biggest complaints with the Galaxy S6 was the battery. Not only wasn't it removable, was also too small. The Galaxy S7 is unlikely to go back to a removable battery, but according to a tipster on Weibo, in early January 2016, Samsung will fit a larger 3000 mAh battery in it. This would be well above the 2550 mAh battery found on the Galaxy S6. However, it looks as though there may be three variations of the S7 in total, with each one using a different type of chipset. According to Sam Mobile, the S7 heading to India will have the same Exynos 7422 chipset as the Galaxy Note 5, while China, Korea and Europe will get one with an Exynos 8890 chip. Meanwhile, those in China or the US will be getting an S7 with a Qualcomm Snapdragon 820. The phone is recently rumored to have ClearForce display, developed by Synaptic, which can feature 3D touch, like Apple iPhone. This display will be more likely to one we have seen with iPhone 6s. According to latest update, we think Galaxy S7 Edge will be the first to have this kind of display from Samsung. The Galaxy Note 5 arrived with a QHD display, but now that the Sony Xperia Z5 Premium has broken the seal on 4K screen technology, we might just see one on the Galaxy S7, but, according to a leaked image found on Chinese social service Weibo, the Galaxy S7 Edge will have a 5.1-inch display with 2K resolution, 2560x1440, and Adreno 530 graphics. One of the major surprises of the Galaxy S7 concerns the main camera, dropped to 12-megapixel shooter rather than a 16-megapixel. Samsung is dropping pixels, but the camera is rumored to have a f/1.7 aperture. It is an important upgrade compared to the previous Galaxy S generation. Well-known case maker, Spigen, recently revealed various protective cases designed for the Samsung Galaxy S7, S7 Plus, S7 Edge, and Galaxy S7 Edge Plus. In early December, a report from Korea suggested that the Galaxy S7 design will be very similar to its predecessor, the S6. The decision comes at a time when Samsung is looking to cut costs in an increasingly competitive market. Samsung is manufacturing Samsung Galaxy S7 and S7 Edge smartphones with 4GB of random access memory. It will have UFC 2.0 feature, which will fasten your video recording experience, with fast data storage. These phones will be available with 32, 64, and 128GB internal storage. This year Samsung is going to reintroduce external micro SD card option with Galaxy S7 series, which is really a great move by the company. As most of the customers are not happy with their limited storage mobile phones. Google has just announced Android Marshmallow, so it doesn't take a genius to work out that Samsung will use it for the Galaxy S7. Like the Google Nexus 6P, OnePlus 2, Microsoft Lumia 950 and many other phones, the Galaxy S7 is rumored to have the reversible USB Type-C port for plug-in Indo charger. The next generation Galaxy S7 smartphone may have embedded SIM cards, as we are moving towards next level. According to FT.com, GSMA, a worldwide authority for mobile operators, is soon going to announce this. So, we can expect eSIMs are going to be a new feature to Samsung S7. With these new SIM cards, You can use multiple networks without changing your SIMs. We have got this one nailed down pretty well. The Galaxy S6 launchpad, MWC 2015, and the Galaxy S5 launchpad, MWC 2014. So the Galaxy S7 release date will undoubtedly coincide with MWC 2016, that's February the 22nd to the 25th, 2016. It will cost approximately, same as its predecessor S6, around $800.